I just picked up this small fishing boat recently and have some work to do on it. It needs a little TLC in a whole lot of areas, but in this particular video I'm going to show you how to make a motor stand so you can take one of these outboards off and perform maintenance on it. So a lot of you have seen my videos, have maybe seen me work in metal, and I tend to build a lot of things in wood though, and I'm going to build this motor stand out of just a bunch of leftover wood that I have from other projects. If you were to purchase this wood at Home Depot new, this project would probably cost you, probably, I would guess, depending on what you want to build the stand out of, it might cost you max 20 bucks. Okay, so I'm going to build this stand roughly the size of the where the transom clamp is. So that comes out to about 41, because I want to give it enough room on the bottom there so the lower unit doesn't scrape the ground. Okay, the basic idea of this is we're going to have two uprights. And we're going to have 2 feet to it. Some diagonals to give it some strength. We'll have this piece right here for the outboard to lean on, and then we'll probably have another cross brace here or here or somewhere like that, just to give some more structural integrity. Then the motor will clamp onto here. How do you like that? That's a nice drawing. Might as well give it some eyes and a mouth too. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is take this 2x6 and I'm going to cut this down. So I put this speed square. It's tough for me to mark this while I'm holding this, but more or less, you're going to mark this piece and then you're going to cut it with a circular saw. Okay, now I have a 4x4 and I'm going to be cutting this at approximately 40 inches. No, we'll say 40 and a half inches. Okay, and then I'm just going to have to cut this and cut this, rotate it, and I'm gonna cut two of those. Okay, now I have these pieces cut, and I'm gonna basically just do this, do that, and then fasten it on the bottom. So you have a little bit coming out here, but most of the leg is coming out that side, because you want the weight of the motor to be supported by these. In fact, maybe I'll just have it come about this far, just a little bit. And you fasten that bottom. And then we're going to take these guys right here and just put these up against here, like this, and fasten them. We'll cut off the part that hangs over, but this will give us even more support. Angular support. And then I'll attach this to the uprights going across, and it'll make a nice little stand. This is literally something you can build in, I would say, under an hour if you have some tools. Now, I would say if you want to do it fast, just nail it together, but if you want to do it right, I would say screw it together and pre-drill with deck screws, and don't use pressure treated probably. But this is all scrap wood, and I'm going to be using my pass load nailer because it makes life so much easier and fast. But not everyone has one of these. My suggestion though is watch my other video about pass load nailers, and it might sell you on wanting to buy one, because I've used this all the time when I'm putting slapping stuff together. Now, doing really nice finish work, no, not the same thing, but a pass load for cranking together something like this real fast. It's all a matter of just pushing down, pulling the trigger. I'll show you what this looks like in a little bit. Okay, so I got that in. The final part's to put these at a diagonal, roughly like that, kind of 45s, and that'll give extra strength as to all the weight will be on this side of the stand. So I ended up being one shy of these, so I had to come out to my junk pile here. I highly suggest anyone have a junk pile. And I guess, let me see here. See if this one will work. Yeah, definitely. I'll have to cut it down a little bit. But actually, I won't have to because I'll be cutting off the excess anyways. So I highly suggest you have a junk pile. And you can keep in your junk pile, you can keep supplies of wood or maybe an old apple press that you built, or prototype picnic tables. Actually, this is worth showing. This prototype picnic table, it's something that was designed to break into two different benches. This has been outside for a long time, but the back of this, it's missing its pairing here, but this is supposed to go up like this, and then you turn the other bench around and do the same thing and then lock it together, and it becomes a picnic table. But when you're done, you just make it into benches and place them around your backyard. Maybe someday I'll retry building this and do a video on it. Okay, so I got two more boards, and the idea is I'm gonna put these here, attach them, and then I'm gonna cut off the slop that comes over here, just to make it cleaned up a little bit, so there's not sticking down below and above. Okay, now you're just gonna run this up here and cut this piece off right here. Ew. Got a little messy, but more or less you're just gonna cut this off so it's nice and clean with the line of the thing here. Now you can either throw like some kind of dolly underneath it. You could put some casters under these legs, or you could go get a dolly, or a hand truck, I should say, like this one. And once you get the motor onto it, you could just wheel it into your shop where you can do your maintenance. See, I have to take this one over to here. I'm probably gonna end up using the hand truck instead of this though, because it's not very sturdy here. It's just too small of a dolly. But casters or a hand truck would probably be your best bet after this. So instead of doing that wobbly little dolly, I decided I'm gonna use a hand truck to move this over to the outboard, and then to move the outboard over into my shop area. So try to get your stand as close to the outboard as you can before you move it. And then if it has like an electric start, you're gonna have to disconnect from the battery, and then anything else that it might be connected to, like if it's connected to the gas, you're gonna have to take that off. You just unsnap it right there. And then normally you're gonna wanna try to do this with two people instead of one. I'm a fairly large guy. I'm 6'6", 270, so I can usually pick stuff like this up. We'll see though. This looks like it's gonna need a little bit of TLC once I get into the shop too, just to make sure that this has better insulation and maybe clean up these bolts a little bit. And then you're gonna just loosen these transom clamps. You might have some through bolts too you might have to deal with, so keep that in mind. But you're gonna loosen these up, and then this should come loose from the transom, and you pick this up and carry it over to here. These are all loose, and I moved this to here, so I have like all of a foot to carry this, because this thing is heavy. Oh man, that is not easy. As I was lifting this up, it locked. It swiveled and locked. I don't know if you can see it. It locked on. And I couldn't get it to seat onto this stand. So you have to try to make sure that it doesn't lock up in an upward position, or else it's gonna be hard for you to get it on here, and then you're gonna have to put it back onto the transom and situate yourself again. And just realize this thing weighs, I don't know, over 100 pounds. So don't do this unless you have a hoist or two people, or unless you wanna be really adventurous and take some risks with your own safety. So once you get the transom locks on the clamp screwed into this, I'm taking our hand truck and I'm gonna wheel this over to the shop carefully. I think this boat stand works pretty well with a hand truck. This is very manageable. Okay, I got that moved over here right by the shop so I can do some work on it. So there you go. Here is a boat stand that you can make in under an hour. You can use it with a hand truck, or you can put casters under it, and it'll give you a space that you can work on your outboard so it's not attached to your boat and you can go boating in the meantime.